What's up, my brothers from another mother? We've got a interesting conversation we need to have about the sexual marketplace and the intricacies of hypergamy. I did a video a little while ago on what hypergamy is. There's a card up on the top right. You should check it out if you haven't seen it. But this is going to deal with the micro when it comes to the sexual marketplace and the male versus female sexual strategy and some very cold, hard, uncomfortable truths about what hypergamy is when it comes to open hypergamy. So first of all, let's talk about the male-female sexual strategy. Pretty straightforward. It's widely accepted that this is what it is. It's not disputed. The male sexual strategy is unlimited access to unlimited women, and the female sexual strategy is hypergamy, more specifically open hypergamy. So let's use this illustration to try to go down this rabbit hole and explain the significance of this discovery. This is through my own observations, you know, personally, and through all the guys that I've coached. So we'll put it in perspective this way. You guys are probably familiar with the game of soccer. It's obviously the most popular game on the planet. So we've got a soccer pitch and one goal at one end and another goal at the other. Let's say that the soccer pitch is a sexual marketplace actively being on it. One goal is the male sexual strategy, which is unlimited access to unlimited women, and the female sexual strategy on the other side, their goalpost is open hypergamy. And all that hypergamy is really is, you know, the ability to lock down the best provisioning, best providing, highest value male that they can secure. That's all that is. Again, the card was up on the top right earlier on, so if you haven't seen that, pause this, click that, watch that first, then come back. So we're going to get down to the nitty-gritty and some uncomfortable truths. Now, when you get into a relationship, marriage, LTR, live-in, whatever, you're dating on a long-term basis and you have the talk. The talk usually comes from her. She'll say something to you like, well, where do we stand? Where is this going? Are we exclusive? And you both agree on some sort of, you know, facilitated agreement on how the relationship should operate. Now, here's the thing. If you're going to abandon your sexual strategies and be in a monogamous relationship, both the men and women need to abandon their sexual strategy. So the man, by all accounts and through the agreement, needs to abandon his sexual strategy, which is, of course, unlimited access to unlimited women. So monogamy, of course. The female sexual strategy, she would need to abandon open hypergamy. Now, here's the difference. The abandonment, the way that men think about it versus the way that women think about it are two separate and different things. So I'll give you a very astute example. You know, you could be dating for a while, a couple of years, and, you know, you've stopped seeing other women guys. You've deleted your dating apps and all that sort of stuff. And you're an exclusive monogamous relationship sort of thing. So you've abandoned your sexual strategy. You're off the soccer pitch. You're not trying to score any goals right now. Here's the thing, though. The way that hypergamy works is that it's so ingrained in culture in such a deep level, and it's very hard for women to avoid. So, for example, she might be monogamous with you or declare monogamy. You know, the universal standard, according to Esther Perel, is declared monogamy but clandestine adultery. That's basically the way that most of the West works. But let's just set that aside for a second. If she's on social media, fellas, and she's making consistent, regular posts, she's not selling a product or a service using social media to promote a business, for example. So the business, or more specifically, what she's promoting is herself. So if you see daily, multiple times a day, posts by her soliciting the attention of other people, more specifically, I mean, if it's photographs, sexy photographs, selfies, that's a very bad sign. But even if it's not, if there's regular posts looking for engagement, hey, what do you think of this? DM me your feedback on this. Here's a survey. Click this and respond. Send me your feedback. She's basically got what my friend George calls a box of dicks. Her phone is essentially soliciting the attention of other men. So it's not always, you know, Steve from accounting or Kevin from sales that might be, you know, allowing her to facilitate open hypergamy. The very nature of regular posts on social media, which pretty much all women use these days, soliciting attention from the outside world, gives them an opportunity to turn on the radar and scan the horizon for what? A better provisioning male. Because what ends up happening is there's so many thirsty betas out there. They slide into her DMs, they leave comments, they'll try to contact her. And if it's not the thirsty betas, it could be ex-boyfriends, it could be other, you know, potential prospects that may deem her a high enough value woman. So again, if she's an attractive woman and she's making regular posts on social media, the thing that you have to understand about female nature is they're not going to take ownership for it. Their solipsism doesn't allow them to. They're probably going to deny it. In fact, right now in the comments, you're going to look and they're probably going to say, well, you're wrong, or, you know, blah, blah, blah. It's mostly pointing and sputtering. But I'm only pointing to the cold, hard facts. Sorry. Men are getting off the soccer pitch and not seeing other women. Women, however, if they're still making regular posts on social media soliciting attention, whether it's selfies or looking for feedback, DM me this, take this poll, they are trying to optimize their hypergamous nature, and I don't believe it's intentional. I don't think it's something that they're trying to do intentionally, but it's inadvertent simply because of what female nature is. So that is a cold hard truth, a cold hard truth bomb, if you will, about the nature of the sexual marketplace and the dynamics between men and women. When we're told to abandon our sexual strategy and not see other women, men, you need to expect her to do the same. Their sexual strategy is open hypergamy, and if they're constantly seeking the attention and validation from other people, guess what? She's still on the soccer pitch playing the game. You should be on it too. There you have it, fellas. Leave a comment below. I know this is going to be a controversial video. Some of you guys are going to hate it. Some of you are going to love it. Share it with somebody that needs to see it. I think it's a profound thing to consider for both men and women. Let me know what you think. We'll see you guys in the next video. By the way, if you want to make a request for a video topic, I'll put a card up on the top right. I've got a shout out to something at the end of every video. You just click that, you make a small donation, and then send me an email with the topic it is that you want me to cover. Hope you guys enjoyed the video again. See you guys later. Peace.